Hi friends, the next derivation is on the topic of RAC. This derivation is very brief. So you see here, with evaporative cooling, and in previous video you derived without evaporating cooling. So this is a process here, you see figure, only heat exchanger is used, but with evaporative cooling we use evaporator. We use here evaporator, and this evaporator having refrigerant. This refrigerant, it may be ether or liquid nitrogen. These refrigerant used as ether or liquid nitrogen. So you see here this is evaporator, heat exchanger, and here ambient air as like this, and this ambient air goes into ramp. After little bit pressure and temperature increasing, it may goes into main compressor. After compression, more temperature and pressure is increases up, and some part of compressed air goes to be combustion. And some part of it is goes to the heat exchanger. Here heat exchanger, and then for lowering temperature, it goes into evaporator having refrigerant, ether or liquid nitrogen. And after that, it goes to cooling turbine connected a shaft to drive a exhaust fan, and then it is goes to the atmosphere. So this is, and after that cooling, it goes to the air to the cabin here. So here simple diagram. First to second, this is ambient pressure, cabin pressure you see here, ramming pressure, and 1 to 2 ramming pressure, 2 to 3 main combustion pressure, and after that here heat addition, heat extraction. And notice friend here 4 to 5, so here 4 to 5 shows without evaporative cooling, 4 to 5, but after evaporation used much more lowering temperature, then 4-5 it is used at with evaporative cooling, 4-5 with evaporative cooling, temperature and entropy diagram. So here you see simple diagram, here not evaporator used. So simple, all formula is simple. On previous video you see some formula, MA equals to 14,000 Q Cp T6 and here T5-. In this figure case, you see here 4-5 with evaporative cooling. So here formula will become T6-5-, this same, and P equals to MSCP T3-T2, always same, U1, 2, and 3. This is another formula, kilowatt, and COP 14,000 Q divided by MSCP T3-T2, and it will become 14,000 Q P. It denoted here P multiplied 3600. And after that ME equals to QE multiplied T divided by HFG. So what is this? This is the initial mass of evaporant required to be carried for the given flight time. If flight time is given, then this is ME equals to initial mass of evaporation. So what is QE? QE equals to heat to be removed in evaporation. QE, heat to be removed in evaporation, taken as kilojoule per hour. T, taken as flight time in hour. And HFG, latent heat of evaporation. It is also taken as what? Taken as kilojoule per kg. QE, kilo, taken as kilojoule per hour. T, flight time, taken as R, and HFG, kilojoule per kg. Heat, QE, heat to be removed in evaporation, T, flight time, and HFG, latent heat of evaporation. So this is normal formula, and we not describe in detail, we describe very briefly, and next video we solve some numerical. So thank you.